Nung grade 5 po ako, pumasok po ako sa school ng iyak. Hindi ko po masabi sa mga teachers ko kasi po family problem siya. Pero yung reason po is, tinalo po ako ng papa ko. Nag-aalala na po yung mga teachers ko. Tinawag po nila sa Bantay Bata.
The story of Bantay Bata began in the heart.
I saw a news item where a child was beat up by her mother and then eventually died. Maybe if there was a number that child could have called, that death could have been prevented. So that's how it was born, and we took 6 months to prepare. We worked with DOJ, with the SWD. What happened on the day that it started, that was February 14, we got 1,000 calls. It was crazy. 40 of them were serious cases where the child's life was in danger. I was horrified. I said, go for rescue.
The Bantay Bata 163 hotline started with a desire to embrace all children and make them feel safe. I would always hear Gina say, the children of the world are the future. Our only purpose and mission is to help children step out of a pattern of abuse that is almost impossible to do on their own.
From manual operating system done by social workers, Bantay Bata 163 upgraded to a more efficient hotline service, providing a web-based database with necessary information relevant to the crafting of welfare policies for children all over the Philippines. From establishing a rescue hotline for abused children, Bantay Bata took on new endeavors to fulfill its mission of creating a better world for the Filipino child.
And so we had to think of ideas and strategies to keep the child safe. One of the things we do is feeding programs, because we have found kung gutom sila, they won't even listen to you. So what we found is that when we do it, one, the nutrition goes up, and then two, by creating stronger families, the child abuse goes down.
Nakita ko pong mas naging mapagmahal na po yung papa ko, maalaga, at pinipilit na po niyang hindi magalit.
Whoa.